Thank you, Jesus. 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 Shh. Lift your hands. Take a seat, worship, my daughter.
Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Oh, Jehovah.
Bibles, whether you have your Bible on the phone or you have now improved, you have entered into technology or you have updated yourself. You know, a computer of 1997, it cannot work in our time. It can't work. It is very slow. And it is out of fashion. There are most of you, not that God does not want to bless you. God is ready to bless you, but you have refused to update yourself. You are in 2017, yet you are looking like you are in 1997. So, update is a personal empowerment. You just need to update yourself. Every day of my life, I make sure that I read one book. Every day. Every day. That's the reason each and every day I minister, I teach you new sermons. And all my sermons, if you say that they are boring, then it is you who is boring. It's you who is making the sermon to be boring. Am I talking to somebody here? So, you need to update yourself. Tell everybody, you need to update yourself. Just look at your neighbor. Tell them you need to update yourself. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. Clap hands. Are you jealous? Or you are jealous of the way they are looking on Facebook? If you are not spiritual, I'll be speaking nonsense in your physical ears. But spiritually, it is power and brings edification. The Bible says the foolish things of this world edifies. So there are sometimes there are things that I can utter that are foolishness in your physical ears, but spiritually, they carry a meaning. Am I talking to somebody here? Ephesians chapter 1, verse 11 to 16. Rise up on your feet. We are going to read that scripture together. Hallelujah. Okay, we're going to read verse 17 together. Just rise up, rise up, rise up, rise up, rise up. And if your friend has got no Bible, please just share with them. Just share with them. Are you there? Are you there? Hey, are you there? Why is your voice not here? Are you there? Ephesians chapter 1, verse number 17. I want us to read on top of our voices, braggadocious, just to make the devil feel very bad. 1, 2, 3, go.
And revelation in the knowledge of him, of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is in the hope of his calling, and what he riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints.
Let's read verse 17. 1, 2, 3, go.
That the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him.
Verse 18. 1, 2, 3, go.
The eyes of your understanding enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling, and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints.
Father, I pray. Amen. As your word is coming,
amen.
Lift our spiritual eyes.
Amen.
May we never be the same again.
Amen.
As your word is coming, let it come in healing and deliverance.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Speak to us in revelation.
Amen.
Our hearts are ready.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Clap hands for Jesus Christ. Take your seats. Ephesians chapter 1, verse number 7, the Bible says that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, lift your right hand, shout glory 3 times.
Glory,
shout glory 3 times.
Glory,
that the Father of our Lord Jesus, remember, and the angel says, the Father of glory, So you must understand, number one, the kind of a God that we deal with. He is not just a God. He is a God filled with glory. Now the word glory, right? The word glory in Greek means kabod. Doxa. And the word doxa comes from a terminology which means something that is heavy or something that comes on a person and a person cannot even lift it up. So when we talk about the glory, we are talking about the heaviness of God, the splendor, the beauty of God. The beauty of God being displayed upon the lives of people. The glory is in so many dimensions. The glory of God is in so many dimensions. Now, the God that we deal with, He is not just a normal God. He's a God surrounded by glory. Now you must understand that the glory is what? The heaviness, the weight of God upon somebody. And that's the reason when we are in the service, when the glory of God comes down, when the glory of God comes down, you will find that even men can't stand up. Because it is a word from God that comes to take over and to change the whole entire environment. There is the glory of the environment. There is the glory of the environment. And there is the glory of the state house. Isn't it? And there is the glory of the president. When Barack Obama came here in South Africa, we have best technology here in South Africa. Powerful technology. But I wonder why President Barack Obama did not use our cars. The people from America, they had to bring their own cars. Put them on the plane. And they brought them to South Africa. And you could see that these cars, they are really different from our own cars. There is the glory of Obama. Each and every president has the glory. That's the reason every time when they appear, you will see people shouting. Others, they will be crying, yet they can't even heal a spiritual people. Because when the glory has been manifested, you cannot see any weakness. Now, the Bible says, verse 17, let's read together. 1, 2, 3, go. Hey, come on. 1, 2, 3, go.
The glory of God, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of Him.
Now, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, so whatever glory we see, whatever splendor we see, whatever beauty we see, it has the source. And the source is God Almighty. Now, let's go to, want to raise something here. Look, the Father of glory may give unto you the spirit of wisdom. The spirit of wisdom. Lift your right hand, say, the spirit of wisdom. Shout it again.
The spirit of wisdom.
Wisdom is not a wish. You don't wish to have wisdom. I've captioned my sermon this evening as the spirit of wisdom. The spirit of wisdom. The spirit wisdom. It says the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ may give you the what? The what?
The spirit of wisdom.
The what?
The spirit of wisdom.
The Father of our Lord Jesus, who is the Father of glory, may give you the spirit of wisdom. So you must understand that wisdom, it is not a wish.
Amen.
Wisdom is a personality.
Amen.
Wisdom is above thinking. Wisdom is a personality. The Father of our Lord Jesus Christ may give you. So it is a desire and it is a wish of God that you may have access in this personality. That's the reason most of you are stranded, because you don't have this personality. You are stranded. You don't know what kind of a business to embark on. You don't know what kind of a husband to marry, because they are a lot. You don't know where to start your ministry. Now, the wisdom that we are talking about, there are four kinds of wisdom. There is a wisdom that is called the Sophia kind of a wisdom. Karabahati
gibi. Receive.
Let me just stop.
I receive.
Let me just stop. Now, the Father of glory may give you, not your neighbor, you. So remember that it is the wish and it is a desire of God that you may move in wisdom. But you can never move in wisdom without first understanding what is wisdom or how does wisdom work. There's a lot of people, they have all what it takes, but they don't have wisdom. Now you must understand that it is a desire of God that you may have what? Wisdom. He said, I wish that the Father of glory may give you wisdom. Not just wisdom, but the Spirit. The Spirit of wisdom. Let me take you deeper here. Isaiah chapter 11. Isaiah 11. Wake up the sound. Marika Susha. Osha Susha da. Masusha diu. La Susha. La Susha de do. La do sova. Le reno shasa.
I receive.
Jesus, I love you so much, Jesus.
Now, Isaiah chapter 11, verse number one. Are you ready?
Amen.
I want us to read it together. One, two, three, go.
And there shall come forth a rod
out of the streams of Jersey, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. Verse 2, number 1, come on, let's read. And the Spirit of the Lord. Okay. And the Spirit of the Lord. And the Spirit of the Lord. May the Father of our Lord Jesus give you the Spirit of wisdom.
Amen.
Even Jesus, the prophet Isaiah, he's prophesying. He said, this guy, Jesus, he's not just a man.
Amen.
He's not just going to rule based on what at school. There is a need of a personality. And this personality, when he enters the life of a person, he makes a life better.
Amen.
And the Spirit of the Lord. Now, the first thing, the first prophecy is that they shall come forth a rod. Now, the word the rod there symbolizes authority. Psalms 123. I told you that if you are not spiritual, you don't love the word, you are going to leave no prophecy here. We don't prophesy. No prophecy. He is all about breaking scripture. Are you there?
Amen, Papa.
Just a minute, just a minute. Roshade. Psalms 23. We're going to read on top of our voices. Don't forget the scriptures that I've given you, because we are coming there. 1, 2, 3, go.
The Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not want. Verse 2. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. Verse 3. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Verse 4. Yea, though I walk through the valleys of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod.
Amen. Amen.
Thy rod.
Amen.
Thy rod.
Amen.
And they shall come forth. They shall come forth out of the springs, out of the loins, out of the bloodline of Jesse. Who is Jesse? Jesse is the father of David.
Amen.
And there is a prophecy in the book of Revelation chapter 5 where there was a vision that John saw. Go to Revelation chapter 5. Kasigahate. Hey, today you will open scriptures like crazy. Revelation. Don't forget all these scriptures. We are going back. We are going back. We are going back. The word is sweeter.
Amen.
Sweeter than honey. Revelation chapter 5, verse 1. 1, 2, 3, go. And I saw in the right hand of him that sat on the throne a book written within and on the backside sealed with 7 seals. Verse 2. And I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, who is worthy to open the book, to loose the seals thereof. Verse 3. And no man in heaven, nor on the earth, neither under the earth, was able to open the book, neither to look thereon. Verse 4. And I wept much, because no man was found worthy to open and to read the book, neither to look thereon. Verse 5. And one of the elders said unto me, weep not. Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, hath prevailed to open the book and to loose the 7 seals thereof.
Amen.
So Jesus, he's coming out from the what? From the lineage of Jesse. He is coming out from the lineage of Jesse. And Jesse was the father of David.
Amen.
Am I talking to somebody here?
Amen.
Now, Psalms 23, the Bible says, for thy rod, that's what? Let's go back. I'm about to show you something here. Whew. Holy Spirit, fill my heart and of your will. Now, verse 4, I want us to read together. 1, 2, 3, go. Yea, though I walk through the valleys of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. These are two different things here.
Amen.
There is a rod and there is a staff.
Amen.
There is a rod and there is a staff.
Amen.
The staff is used for shepherds. Look. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Verse 5. Thou preparest a table before me in the praises of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Verse 6. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord. Now, look. Thy rod and thy staff. You need to understand the difference between the rod and the staff.
Amen.
But the Bible says, thy rod and thy staff. Now, in the book of Isaiah chapter 11, the Bible says, and there shall come out a rod out of the house of Jesse. Now, the rod there symbolizes what? Authority. Amen. Authority, amen. Which is Jesus Christ. Am I talking to somebody here?
Amen.
There shall come out authority. There shall come out a new king. And this new king is going to be the savior of the world. He's going to be the redeemer of humanity.
Amen.
And this king, he's going to come out from the lineage of Jesse.
Amen.
So the rod there.
I receive.
Scriptures are coming here. Scriptures are coming.
Amen.
I receive. Exodus 4, verse 17. I can see scriptures in the Bible. Look what Moses used. I want to show you.
Amen.
Look what Moses used. Look what Moses was using to perform miracles. Even Moses used the authority. Who is Jesus Christ?
Amen.
To perform all miracles.
Amen.
Let's read. Kaziga balatush. My God. Exodus 4 verse 17. Are you there?
Amen.
Are you there?
Amen.
Are you there?
Yes, Papa, we're there.
Are you there? Look what God is telling Moses. 1, 2, 3, go. And thou shalt take this rod in thy hand, wherewith thou shalt do signs.
Amen. Amen.
You shall take this rod. It is through the rod of Moses that God gave authority.
Amen.
So the rod there symbolizes what?
Authority.
So going back to that scripture, Isaiah chapter 11, the Bible says, there shall come out a rod out of the house of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. And verse 2, the Bible says, the Spirit of the Lord.
Amen.
The Spirit of the Lord.
Amen.
The Spirit of the Lord. Amen. Shall do what? Shall be upon him. Shall be upon him. The Spirit of the Lord. He is a man of authority.
Amen.
He will not just rule by authority. But this authority needs a personality.
Amen.
Of wisdom. That's the reason the only way to kill a person is to give him authority.
Amen.
The only way to know a person, give him power. He will abuse it. But the only way to deal with a person, give him power. Without wisdom. The power will kill him.
Amen.
Hey, there shall come out authority. I know this man, Jesus. He is a man of authority. But he will not just rule based on the authority, on the power. But that power must be controlled by the personality. And this personality is wisdom. The Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, that he may give you the Spirit of wisdom. Spirit of the Lord. You know the reason why you are not flourishing? The reason why people don't know you? The reason why people don't know your company is because you don't have the Spirit of the Lord. The Spirit of the Lord is a spirit to take over. That's the reason. Look, when I enter a place, When I enter a place, I use the Spirit of the Lord.
Amen.
I become the landlord. That's where this word is called the landlord. Because he's the Lord of the land.
Amen.
So, for you to own land, you must be what? Hey. For you to have land in this country, what do you need? You need the Spirit of what? Of the landlord. The Spirit of the Lord. The Spirit of the Lord is the one that gives you ability to possess your possession.
Amen.
That's the reason most of you are here. Nothing, completely nothing. You don't have a job. You don't have a car. You are renting. You have been renting for the past 11 years. You are not married. There is nothing to show. You are 25 years. You have been kept. You are asking your mother 20 rand. It's an embarrassment. And the Spirit. And the Spirit of the Lord. You know, look. One of the secrets of my ministry is because I have too much the Spirit of the Lord. Even if you don't know me, the moment I pass you, I just bypass you, you will just feel, you say, who healed me?
Power.
It's the Spirit of the Lord that causes your business to flourish. Look, places does not matter. Places does not make people. Are you listening to me here? People make places, not places making people.
Amen.
Are you listening to what I'm trying to say?
Yes.
You need the Spirit of the Lord. If you are a minister, you need the Spirit of the Lord. If you are a pastor, you need the Spirit of the Lord. If you are a businesswoman, you need the Spirit of the Lord.
Amen.
And the Spirit of the Lord. That's what we call the Spirit of Lordship. You become a Lord in a certain area. And you don't become a Lord without the personality of wisdom. I'm sure there is. There are most of you. I will show you. All the seven spirits that are mentioned in the book of Isaiah chapter 11. There are about seven spirits. Number one, there's the Spirit of the Lord. Number two, there's the Spirit. Let's go there. Whew. Have your way. Have your way, Holy Spirit, fill my heart. Have your way. Okay. Verse number two. Are you there?
Amen.
Are you there?
Amen.
Now, let's see verse number two. 1, 2, 3, go. And the Spirit of the Lord, number one, shall be upon him. The Spirit of wisdom. Huh? The Spirit of what?
Wisdom.
The Lord. The Spirit of wisdom. The Spirit of what?
Understanding.
The Spirit of counsel. The Spirit of mighty. The Spirit of knowledge. And the Spirit of the fear of the Lord.
Amen.
How many are they? Seven spirits. Seven spirits.
Amen.
Now, when I talk about wisdom, remember that wisdom is a personality. Wisdom is a person. Proverbs chapter 4. Proverbs chapter 4. Kasabu kachaniyaka. Lerush idia bahase. Lashidia prokotozia. Zozu zezia karadosh. Merush kabahase. Are you there? Remember, we are looking at what? Wisdom. It's like these people, they are listening to me. That's the reason I'm coming. Yeah. It's like they are listening to me so much. Are you there?
Amen.
Proverbs 4. Proverbs is found after Revelation. I know some of you have already gone there. You'll be like, I just need to check. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want us to read verse number five. Verse number 5. We're going to read together. 1, 2, 3, go. Verse number 5. Verse number 5. 1, 2, 3, go. Get wisdom. Get understanding. Forget it not. Neither decline from the words of my mouth. Verse 6. Forsake her not. Okay. Forsake her not. So wisdom is a person.
Amen.
You're not getting this. Look, verse number 5. The Bible says, get wisdom. Remember, wisdom is a spirit. Understanding is a spirit. And the Bible says, forget it not. Which means it is a necessity.
Amen.
You can never do without wisdom. You can never be successful without wisdom.
Amen.
It is a fundamental principle that you must apply every day of your life. Wisdom must be an ingredient of your life.
Amen.
Praise God. Verse 5, the Bible says, get wisdom, get understanding, forget it not. Neither decline from the words of my mouth. Verse 6, forsake her not. Who? Wisdom. If you forsake wisdom, you become a dupe. Why wisdom? Now, the word wisdom comes from two words. The word wisdom comes from two words. There is wise and dumb. And the word dumb comes from the word kingdom.
Amen.
And the word wise, to be wise, is the ability
Amen.
To know what to do
Amen.
At the right time.
Amen.
The word wisdom, it is to know what to do at a right time. So in the kingdom of God, for you to be triumph, or for you to triumph, for you to be influential, for you to be extraordinary, for you to produce outstanding results, you will need wise domain.
Amen.
You will need this wisdom, these ingredients to rule in the kingdom of God. Because the kingdom of God, it is not just the kingdom of foolish people. The kingdom of God is a kingdom of wise men and the wise women of God.
Amen.
Even the Bible says, then the wise men, in the book of Matthew, the Bible says, the wise men, they followed Jesus. It is wisdom that causes you to even have precious gifts.
Amen.
You will never find a person who is so wise and is poor. Do not forsake her. Do not forsake her. It is a personality that you must apply every day.
Amen.
Let's look at something here. Verse number 7. Okay. Verse number 6. Let's finish. The Bible says, forsake her not, and she shall preserve thee. This personality called wisdom, she has the ability to preserve you.
Amen.
To protect you. To protect. Which means it's not God protecting you anymore. So God does not protect people.
Amen. Power.
You're not getting this. God does not protect people. You want God to protect you? Say God, he does not protect people. I'll show you. In the Garden of Eden, he had to put Adam as a king. There is no king without wise domain. In the garden, Adam was the king. He was leading. The whole entire animals, they were getting instruction from Adam. You will never, look, even God, I will show you. Even God, one day, Adam came up with a plan. He said, these animals, they have stayed without names. Adam said, these animals, they have stayed without names. From the day they were created, there is no name for them. God was not naming them. Even God was waiting upon Adam. God is waiting for you. I will show you something here. God is waiting. Look, there are some certain things that God cannot do. He's a busy God. Up to now, he's still resting. You want God to leave the throne to come and protect you. Yet there is Satan who wants the throne. You are not getting this. You are not getting this. I will show you. Get her. This personality. She will preserve you. She will protect you. She has the ability to close the mouth of your enemies. It's not God anymore. It's this ingredients, this personality called wisdom. Animals, they had no names. And one day, by the wisdom of God connected to Adam, the Bible says Adam began to name them one by one. He says, starting from today, you are going to be elephant. We never see God rejecting or opposing. In fact, God was even saying, it is good. It is good. He named. He said, you, starting from today, you shall be elephant. According to the mind of God. Wrong name. It was not so. The man was connected to the mind of God to the point that he was speaking exactly like God, moving like God, reasoning like God, having the ability like God.
Amen.
Sing like God.
Amen.
Are you listening to what I'm trying to say here?
Yes.
The reason why God had to rest is because he created you so that you can take over.
Amen.
You are the firstborn of God. And every time when the firstborn has grown, the father, he must sit. He must sit. For example, there will be a time in ministry, I will sit down, I will resign. Yes, I will resign. I say, I'm getting old now. I'll begin to use now experience. Now, son, take over. The reason why, look, when was a man created? He was created on which day? On the sixth day, he was created. And on the seventh day, God did what? Rested. Do you know why God rested on the seventh day? Because on the sixth day, he had the ability to create that which looks like him. So that that which looks like him can take over.
Yes. Power.
Now, you look like God. You reason like God. You have the wisdom. The God kind of a wisdom. You have it. Do you want also God to come down again to come and save you? So, you know, people, they are praying now. He said, God, come and save me. Come and save, come and protect me. No. Now, he has given you all things. He has given you all things. He has given you his wisdom. How he functions. He has already opened up the mysteries of how he operates in his kingdom. And then you want God to protect you again. Do not forsake her. For she will protect you. Do you want protection? So which means protection does not come from God. Protection comes because of this personality. There are things that God will not protect you from. For example, okay. Are you born again? Or born againest? Huh? Okay. Imagine you are born again. You go on the bar. On the bar. You go and take 7 bottles of beer. You sit down. Eh? You sit down. And you are busy drinking majestically. Busy what? Majestically. Drinking like you are dying. And while you are drinking, another drunkard appears. And he takes a bottle and breaks your head. And to a Christian, why did God protect you? Okay, God does not protect. There are things he doesn't protect. Today, just go. He said, today I'm going to steal. With your born againish, you'll be delivered. Is he a protector? He is a protector. But you are lacking the fundamental principle of wisdom. You are in a wrong place at a wrong time, and you are not doing a right thing. So you are expecting God to protect. Yes, he's a protector. But the place where you are, when we deal with wisdom, what is wisdom is knowing what to do at a right time, being at the right place at the right time. Amen. You are at the wrong place, so God cannot protect you.
Amen.
Even if he was supposed to send Michael, Michael would have been detained. Even people now, they are praying in wickedness. Even a thief, when he's going to steal, he will pray. He said, I am praying. He said, oh God, I pray because you are a merciful God. Yes, he is a merciful God, but you are applying his mercy at the wrong place. Oh God, you are a merciful God. In his mercy, right there when you go, he will mess you. He will mess you up. Now imagine you are at the beer parlor. He's a protector. Why did he protect you? Eh? There is a law of South Africa. Even on the road, there is a law. And if you must stay away from trouble, you need this personality. They will tell you that over speeding kills. And you will come with your own revelation. You say, speeding is good. It makes you reach faster. There is a law where they have even stated in their books, saying that over speeding kills. You come with your own revelation and say over speeding makes you reach faster. And when you are involved in a car accident, you sit down and say, oh God, why did you protect me? Didn't you say? So we have blamed God. We have blamed God even in places that even is not supposed to be. It's like you are taking God. You want God to enter the bar. To do what? I'm asking you. I'm asking you. You are in a bar. You want God to come and remove you. Who took you there? So you will need the wisdom. He's a personality. The Bible says, she will what? She will preserve you. The word to preserve, it means to protect from attack. So before they attack you, she'll be there to give you a wisdom on how to run away from some certain attacks of the enemy. The Bible says, a wise man perceives evil from afar and he runs away. That's the reason every time when I see somebody is about to attack me, it's not that I am a coward. There are some certain battles, you don't need to fight them. Tell me about, there are some certain battles, don't fight.
There are some certain battles,
don't fight. Use wisdom to run away.
Use wisdom to run away.
Amen.
Power.
The Bible says, a wise man perceives evil from afar and he runs away. He's not running because because he is a coward. He's running away because of wisdom. He has already accessed that this battle, it is beyond my strength. There are some of you, you will fight against enemies that are above your strength. They will kill you. Before you fight, look at the one you're fighting against. Look at also your side. It is wisdom that will give you access to access your enemies, to access their weaknesses. Before you attack, wisdom will begin to ask you questions. You are going to fight. You are going to fight against an enemy that you don't know. He will destroy you. Before you know it, you will join your ancestors with the Holy Ghost on top. Okay. Look at me. Do you know you can die with Jesus? The Jesus who is powerful. Do you know you can die with him inside? Inside you. Ask Peter. He will tell you. In the presence of Jesus, the man was sinking. Jesus was there. That's the reason most of you, if you don't have wisdom, you will be sinking in the presence of the anointing. Sinking like becoming poor. Poor, even the poor call you poorer. Yet the anointing is there for millions. Yet you can't. You can't have access. You are lacking wisdom on how to apply for you to become. How many people are poor in the presence of the anointing? How many people are sick, really sick? Yet the anointing of healing is there. Wisdom. Wisdom. The Bible says a righteous man perceives evil and he runs away. You see, there are some certain battles. There are some certain battles that when they come to me, the first thing I access them. Before I fight, I look at where I am stepping. Wisdom. You are fighting against a president. You are not even connected. You. In 2 days, they will arrest you. You are insulting a man who is very influential. When he just does like this, bam! Soldiers from the pit of hell, the way they come and bastardize you. That's the reason. Before I fight a battle, I first have a meeting between me and her, which is wisdom, a personality. I ask question. If I fight this battle, what is my benefit? There are some certain battles that you are fighting, there is no benefit. You are lacking wisdom. Wisdom will tell you, number one, remember that wisdom is what? The ability to know what to do at a right time. At the right place? Huh? At the right place. So, you know that it is time for church. You are with your boyfriend. You are seated in a dark place. Even where we can't even see. You, I don't know what kind of eyes you have. It is time for church, but you are in a dark place. Your eyes, they are like the eyes of I don't know. It is time for church, but the person, she's where? With her boyfriend. And when she's pregnant, she said, the devil attacked me. No. It's not the devil. She attacked herself. You could not apply wisdom was time for church, not time for your boyfriend. Wisdom will give you the ability to be at a right place. At the right time. Doing something at the right place and at the right time. Right people. There are some certain people that you just need wisdom to disconnect yourself from. When I look at you, there's sometimes when I look at you, I know that you, if I just tell you and say, you, I don't need you. You can be broken. But when I look at your mind, if freedom fighter. You know, there's some certain people, their mind, even the Bible says, he that walketh with the wise shall become wise, which means wisdom is impartable. You can become wise because of a wise man. You can become rich because of the koinonia anointing. Not that you are rich, but because you are found among rich people, they'll be able to contribute. They'll be able to open up how they became great. But you continue walking with poor. Those are the ones you call your friend. Any morning when you wake up early in the morning, you just sit with them, discuss stories that don't have the head and the tail. From morning till evening, and you are eating pap on the road. That's the only thing that you do. That's the only thing that you are comfortable. You are lacking wisdom. You ladies, if you have a boyfriend who only invests at kissing you every time, it's an investment.
Oh, you are laughing, eh?
Hey, wisdom. If he only does the investment of kissing, and you look at his mind, there is nothing. You are in trouble. You are in trouble. Don't just sit with your boyfriend every time you are busy doing things that are outside this world. Sit down. Look, where there is wisdom, there is planning, 100% planning. Before you accept him, you sit down. You reason. Don't look. Love is blind. Marriage will open your eyes. Continue loving him. Love him from January. Love him December. Love him every time. Wait, marriage is coming. You will say, oh, if I had known. Ah, this man is a devil. Devil. You had no time to sit down and apply wisdom in that situation. Ask yourself a question. If I am with this man, how will my life be? If I am in this job, I have been working for the past 16 years. I have been working for the past 17 years. Yet there is nothing to show. What am I going to do? Must I quit? Must I continue? You begin to discuss with wisdom.
Amen.
And the wisdom will give you insight and the revelation.
Amen.
Oh.
Power.
You women. Wisdom will give you the ability to see beyond the suit. Give you the ability to see beyond the suit. Be like, this man, even though he's putting on the suit, FF in his mind. You want to be with a man. You want to be with a man. If you look at him, he's a coward. He's a coward. He can't even protect. Every woman wants protection. Eh? Wait, you will need it when you get married. Every woman wants protection. Imagine, you men. Okay. You women, imagine you are married. And a very giant guy appears. Oh my God, oh my viewers. A giant guy appears. And you are together with your wife. This giant guy beats your wife in your eyes. And you, look. This giant guy beats your wife in your own eyes. And you can't do anything. You're afraid of the muscles. You're like, this guy, if I dare, I can finish. Wisdom will show you ways on how to run away from traps of the enemy, from problems. I did boxing. I'm very good at boxing. Even if you come spiritually, I'll beat you. Physically. Now, the reason why, I want to show you something here. The reason why I did boxing is not just the ability of throwing a punch. Okay? So while you are throwing a punch, you must have wisdom on how to cover your ribs. So at the same time you are fighting, and at the same time, wisdom is giving you the ability to close where the enemy might see an opportunity. For you, you are busy fighting, leaving your ribs open when he beats you. So the Bible says, and the spirit of wisdom. It is a personality that you must apply in every area of your life. Before you embark on a journey, apply wisdom. Before you start a ministry. You know, before I started ministry, I sat down, asked myself, God, I'm about to start ministry. I have seen many failing. What am I going to do which is different? And God is saying, look at all the prophetic ministries. Look at them very well. I said that I was watching every man of God. Every man of God. I sat down. I know each and every man of God who is on the TV. I watched them. And God said, now, see what you can apply, which is new. If you must be influential in business, don't do what everyone is doing. Do what no one is doing. Write this point. If you do what everyone is doing, you will see what everyone is seeing. And if you don't do what everyone is not doing, are you ready? If you do what everyone is doing, you will see what everyone is seeing. And if you don't do what everyone is doing, you will see what they don't see. So the reason why you are seeing the same result is because you are doing what they do. You are singing, you just sing like the way they sing. And every time when you stand, we're like, we have seen this. You dress like the way others are dressing. If you must create attention, dress like Ayakazu Balahate.
I receive it.
So you must be be able to create market for yourself by wisdom. Don't do what everyone is doing. Look at in the industry of music. Watch everyone who has ever made it. Watch what took them on top. You want to be a pastor? You want to be a pastor? You want to be a pastor? You don't have the wisdom. If your members come and shout at you, you will leave ministry. Watch on people that have made it in life. You need that wisdom. Look how they have made it and look their disadvantage. So you build from their disadvantage. You know, when I look at your life, the first thing, I look at you in two ways. Number one, that's the reason I'm able to know you very well. I look at you in two ways. Number one, I look at on your strength, I look at on your weakness. So if I must speak to you, I don't speak to you based on one point. I speak to you based on two points. That's the reason I look at your weakness, I look at your strength. So if I must take over in business, then I must use your weakness. That is a law of business. You use the weakness of your neighbors to go on top. But you don't know all those things. Every time you are busy, we take you for a presentation to present, just to negotiate for a multi-billion. You can't talk. Lacking wisdom. You know, there are some certain people, they lack wisdom. Yeah, they want money. When they see money, it's like they are having a calculator. Ha! Yet a man can't even negotiate for a deal. He can't. He has got no wisdom to learn, to sit down and ask his people, how do you do it? How do you prophesy? Tell me. If he can't tell you, sit under him. Look at him every day. How does he do these things? The way God made me, I've got a crazy spirit. One of my spirit that I have, I've got a crazy faith. If I tell you that we are going to buy, I go to a certain place, I look at the boss, I look at him in his eyes, and I know I'm already drunk with wisdom. He's speaking to me with his grammar. I am using also spiritual grammar. You are seated with a person who carries your million. You can't even talk. Seated with your husband. You are lacking wisdom just to convince him to say, I want to marry you. You can't give him that conviction or a confirmation. When he sits with you, he sees a disaster. I pray for you that wisdom will come on you. I say, I pray that wisdom will come on you.
I receive.
So the Bible says, let's go to that scripture. Proverbs, we are closing. So she will protect you. So if you are needed to be in church, be in church. Let's read that scripture. Verse number what?
Six.
Verse number six, the Bible says, forsake her not, and she will preserve thee. Love her. Love her. So you must be in love with wisdom.
Amen.
You must sleep with her every day. You must love her because she's a personality. There must be intimacy every day.
Amen.
With wisdom. You must desire something new. When you are going to sleep, desire to read something new.
Amen.
Empower yourself.
Amen. Amen.
yourself.
Amen.
You know, there's some certain people, when I look at you, I feel very bad. It's like your father is there. You look at the sons. I took one of my sons somewhere. I was having a show on the TV. Just the way he looked. I was with one of my sons. They asked me, is this really your son? You know, I could not refuse him. I was with him. The man, the way he dressed. White trousers and sneakers with a head sock on his head. And he said, he's my papa. He's papa. I said, which papa? Papa with your head sock. For where? God has opened up doors for you. But yet you enter in the opportunity, yet you go and mess up. You just go and mess up. Because of your just a simple thing. You need wisdom. Look, most of you are looking for employment. Check yourself. You need wisdom.
Amen.
I've worked in a hotel before. I've worked in a hotel for 2 years. I used to be a waiter, taking food. But one of my secrets was my smartness. Sometimes when they look at me, they look at my hair, they look at just my skin, they be like, are you really a waiter? Are you the owner of the hotel, or are you listening? There are opportunities that God will open for you. You will need wisdom to manage a certain level of finances. Look, having money is not a problem, but maintaining what God has given you. That's the reason most of you are lacking wisdom. You are busy misusing money. God gives you money. You are busy misusing money. You just wake up and say, today I'm going to buy suits. No budget. Especially women. Never walk with a woman in the street. You will suffer. They will personally tell you, they will tell you, say, honey, and they will tune their voice, honey. Honey, you know, I was thinking, you know, I just love this dress. Was it on the budget? And you know, they will ask you in the presence of another man when he's buying for his wife. So that you can't refuse. Never buy what you have not budgeted for. You need the wisdom in managing finances. I can tell you, look. The Lord has blessed me so much. But I can tell you something. I don't have no money. Because I've understood that when it comes to management of finances, I'm very bad. Very bad. Even if when you give me 7 million, tomorrow you'll not find it. Once I enter church, I look at the person. For me. You come here, take. You take. By the time I discover my pocket is long. So what I have done is that I have put people around me who are able to control me. Because I've discovered I have a son. And he doesn't eat prayer. He doesn't eat prayer. And he doesn't know. He doesn't know about suffering. Oh, when he sees me, what comes in his mind is, Daddy, he has brought for me. So I must have wisdom in whatever little that I find. Even if I can be able to bless my other sons, but there must be a level of wisdom in managing a certain level of wealth. So the problem is not money. The problem is managing your money. You can't manage. You're overspending. You go and buy Brazilian hair. Did you die when you never had Brazilian hair? Or Chinese hair? Or Nigerian hair? Wisdom is needed in the church. You know you are, look. Your salary is just 10,000 rand. You go and spend at Pick and Pay. You go and spend 9,000 rand. Yet your house is 5,000 rand. And then at the end of it you say, no. I think the devil is after me. It's not the devil. It is you after yourself. Wisdom is needed. On every little thing that God gives you, you need to apply the fundamental principle of wisdom. One time, I was in the flight. That's the reason. You see, you don't know who you are sitting next to. The things that you used to, you misbehave. You will misbehave next to a person who can take you on top. Look, the first thing that I do when I enter a flight, I will greet you. I will greet you. How are you? I introduce myself. My name is Prophet Didi Isaac. And what do you do? No. I'm into this. Where is your company? My company is found at such kind of a place. I remove the business card. This is my business card. Wisdom. You want to be a businesswoman. You don't have even a business card. There's no seriousness. And after that, the man will begin to introduce himself. I was with one of my son. I was in a flight going to Zambia. I sat close to this person, I looked at him and I just greeted him. I said, sir, my name is Joseph. We introduce each other's names, never knowing that this man was carrying it. So after we spoke for a long time, we exchanged numbers. He called me. He said, you know what, I just want to see you. I want us to discuss about the deal of copper and diamond. And up to now, that man, we met in the flight, he's my business partner. And we are talking massive, I'm not talking about 100,000 rand. That is not money, that is change. You see, sometimes if you've never been exposed to a certain level of money, you will see like 100,000 rand, it is money. We're speaking millions, not in rands, in US dollars. And the man, what I did, the man is staying in UK. I told him, I said, okay, we are having such kind of a project. I want you to come over because we are going to present this project to this government. And the man is ready. Just because of the greeting. There are most of you, you don't even greet. You enter your office, you enter the office of your boss, you look at your boss, you do it. Your boss, even if he's ugly, the same ugly man, Your promotion is with him. So even if he's angry, just tell him that, ah, sir, you are handsome. Wisdom. Begin to appreciate your boss. You see, there are some certain people, when you give them something, you just give them money. Say, take this money. They can't even say thank you. They are lacking wisdom. Just to say thank you. Wisdom. That's the reason you even close up your own opportunity, because you are lacking wisdom. A prophet gives you a number, his number, his personal number. You begin to distribute. You have become a distributor. And the first thing, when they call the prophet, he will first ask, who gave you my number? Ah, no, I took it in the spirit. Which spirit? No, the spirit in the Holy Ghost embers. He said, what is the name? Lift your hand and shout hallelujah. You need the wisdom in this time. Days are wicked. There are people that I meet every day. There are some of them. When I tell you that person is very bad, I personally even know that if I connect myself to this man, I am gone. The best thing, let me take 7 steps behind. You need wisdom to run away from some battles. You need wisdom to maintain what God has given you. You need wisdom to maintain your marriage.
Amen.
You need wisdom also to maintain your integrity.
Amen.
That's the reason most of you come here to sit down under me, because of a certain level of wisdom. If I was not a man of wisdom, you would not have even sit down under me. If we are all the same level, there's no reason for you to sit. Let's finish. Number seven. Number six. The Bible says, forsake her not and she will preserve thee. Love her. You need to fall in love with her and she will keep thee. Verse 7, wisdom is a principal thing, which means it is a principle that you must apply every day of your life. And every time you break a principle, you suffer the consequences. And there are most of you have broken the principle of wisdom. That's the reason your businesses are nowhere. The Bible says, wisdom is a principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. It is obtainable. It is available. Do you want to go into ministry? Get wisdom. Do you want to enter in marriage? Get wisdom. Oh God. Oh, what did I just Christ? Can it? I want a man of God. You can't even pray for 20 minutes. Even 20 minutes, you can't pray. And you want a man of God who does not sleep even in the house. He sleeps at the mountain. Just 2 days when he marries you, you'll be there all over. Tweet, 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 tweet. Tweet, 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 tweet. Wisdom. Before you get married as a woman, have wisdom. How will you manage your house? How will you manage your husband? How will you talk to your husband? How will you manage your children if you have children? Some of you say, you know me, I'm too beautiful. I'm too beautiful to have children. Wait when you have yours. You will see how your children misbehave. When they misbehave, bah! You'll be like, ah! You will not even beat your child. You need wisdom on how to handle your children. That's the reason most of you, the reason, do you know? God brings people, and God must give me wisdom on how to handle you so that I can't chase you. Yes, because you are a blessing, you are a blessing, I am a blessing. So it is wisdom that gives me ability to handle you, to know how to handle you. Because if I'm not very careful, I might even chase you. So there are many people who have mega churches, but they are lacking wisdom on how to keep people. It is a blessing to have people. But also it is a blessing to keep people. So you need wisdom in your marriage, in your finances, on how to handle your finances. The Bible says, every good gift comes from the Lord. Even God, when he gives you one rent, it is a blessing from God. He doesn't want you just to misuse what he gives you. He would tell you, my son, that I don't like money. Sometimes I'll just wake up and say, okay, today I don't have money. I just take my jacket. When I just put on my jacket, pa, what happens? What happens? Ask him, he'll tell you. What happens?
Even on Sunday, you just changed your jacket. There was 3,000 in it.
There was 3,000?
3,600.
Just in my pocket. It was 3,000 and some
euros, yes.
Euros. It's about
600 euros.
In my pocket. But you. You know what I did with that money? I want to show you this. Do you know what I did with that money? When I found that money, I took that money. I looked for something in the church. And I added up. What I did, I said, okay, what am I going to do? I looked at the church. I said, oh, I don't love that thing. I don't love it. So what I'm going to do, let me change. You saw we had some equipment. Now we have these ones. Wisdom. You want to have a mega church, you can't invest in church. You're going for cheap things. This church, the investment itself is about 7 million. 7 million. 7 million. 7 million. Nothing, whatever you see here, nothing is rented. You want to start ministry? You need wisdom. Before you start, sit down. Ask yourself. Manage the little that God has given you. You will find that God will begin to bless you abundantly. He will begin to open up doors for you. I was not like this. It's my faithfulness to wisdom that has brought me here. I'm a man of wisdom. Me, when I sit down with you, I don't speak much. When I speak 4 times or 5 times, it's enough. When you ask me a question, I will not answer you right there. But you, when they ask you a question, your mouth will answer and your brain will be contemplating. So there will be confusion between your mouth and your brain. Before you speak something, ponder on it. Yada on it. Have wisdom. What are you talking? To whom are you talking? You know, there's some of you just talk and to whom are you talking that thing? What is the meaning of what you are saying? Is it just all about just speaking? What are you talking about? What is the replication of what you are talking about? Those are the questions you must ask yourself. What am I talking about? What is the meaning of what I'm talking about? And what is the replication or what is the end result? Get wisdom. It is a principal thing. You will grow in your ministry. I have seen people expiring like this in ministry. I don't desire to expire. Me, I don't. Every day I want to improve. I want a new thing. I want God to speak to me even when I get old. I want to be an old man of wisdom, not just having gray hair without wisdom. Gray hair is not wisdom. Wisdom is a personality. You need to apply wisdom in your school, in your business, in your church, in your finances, in your house, in your office. You need wisdom. Lift your hands. Pray for the spirit of wisdom now. Pray.
Masatarabo shatalir katarabo shatalirabo shata. Lika razotaba daleko rebo. Talira Zatarabo, Lika Zatarabo, Shalira Katarabo, Hadalekira Zata, Isopla Hadala Kira Mahadala Kusha Talibo, Shal, Imasa Talira Kotarabo, Shatalaba,
Ekat. Precious name of prayer.
Amen.
Write this first point as we finish. What must I do? What must I do to have wisdom? What must I do to have wisdom? What must I do to have wisdom? Remember that there are different kinds of wisdom. There is a wisdom that you can get from school. It is called intellectual wisdom. There are four kinds of wisdom. There is intellectual wisdom. There is devilish wisdom. There is also human wisdom or Adamic wisdom. And there is also divine wisdom. But what we are talking about, we are talking about the divine wisdom. Remember, it said, may the Father of our Lord Jesus give you the spirit of wisdom. So wisdom is a spirit, but how do you get it? How do you get it? And we are talking about the divine wisdom, which is from above. It is beyond the intellectual wisdom. It is beyond the devilish wisdom. It is beyond the human wisdom. This wisdom, when it comes on you, even though you are not educated, it'll be able to bring a difference. Amen. So how do you get it? Number one, how do you get it? Number one, you must be born again. You can never have access to this wisdom if you're not born again. Even John says, the one who is coming above, from above, the one who is coming from above, the one who is coming from above. So this wisdom comes from above. It is above all. And for you to have access, you must be born again. You must give your life to Jesus. You must give your life to Jesus. Number two, how does this wisdom come? This wisdom comes by the baptism of the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit comes in you, he comes with wisdom. The Bible says in the book of John chapter 14, the Bible says, he shall teach you. He shall teach you all truth. He shall teach you the wisdom of God. How God operates, he will teach you. So the presence of the Holy Spirit or the presence of the Holy Ghost is a presence of wisdom. He is a spirit of wisdom. So every time when you receive him, when you receive him, he begins to teach you some things even your teacher did not teach you. Nobody taught me how to prophesy. But when I went to pray, when I began hearing him, he opened up my ears on how to distinguish the voices. And I know that this is the voice of God. This is the voice of man. Even when you are speaking, I'm able to know that that is the voice of somebody. It is the presence of the Holy Spirit. When he comes, he will begin to teach you all truth. He will make you to know truth. The Bible says, you shall know the truth. He will reveal to you. Not only revealing to you, but he will cause you to know it. He will cause you to know it. Not just to know it, but to live in it. So the baptism of the Holy Spirit is what brings this divine wisdom. There are most of you, you are not even baptized. You're not even baptized. Remember, there's two kinds of baptism. There is a baptism of the water, which is the immersing of the body. The immersing full of the body. And there is also the baptism of the Holy Spirit, which is called the baptism of fire. The baptism of fire, where your spirit is baptized now. Is baptized to speak in other tongues. It is a sign that now you are filled with the Spirit of God. If you read the book of Acts chapter 2, you discover when the Holy Spirit came, the Bible says, then all of them, they were all filled. They were all filled and they began to speak with other tongues. So the presence of the Holy Spirit is a presence of wisdom. And wisdom causes you to speak with other tongues. What do I mean other tongues? Which means you will not just have one language. You will have different languages. He will give you utterance. Praise God. Number three. How does this wisdom come? This wisdom also comes by the Logos. The Logos. How rooted you are in the Word of God. The Bible says in the book of Psalms 1, the Bible says, He's like a tree planted beside the rivers of water, who removes his fruit every season, and whatever he does, it prospers. So this kind of a wisdom, it comes by the Logos. When I talk about the Logos, I am talking about the Word of God. The Word of God. How much you know about the Word of God. How much you know what God is talking about you. There is something that God has said about you in His Word that He wants you to search. You need to search in Scriptures. That's the reason if you read the book of Luke chapter 4, verse number 16, the Bible said, then the book of the prophet was cast unto him. And the Bible says, then Jesus opened up the book. You need to have the habit of opening up the Bible and finding where God has written about you. Which means each and everybody here, there is a scripture that is written about you. Specifically about you, about your situation, about what you are going through. But you need to open up the book. The Bible says when he opened up the book, he found where it was written about him. And the Bible says the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. So the Word of God brings wisdom. The Word of God brings divine wisdom. The more you stay in the Word of God, the more you begin to read the Word of God, the more you stay in the Word, the more you become interested in the Word, is the more you grow in the wisdom of God. Do you want to grow in the wisdom of God? You need to stay in the Word. That's the reason. It is not just about a prophesying. No, you need to prophesy with the Word. There is no prophecy that is above the Word. That's the reason every time I want to prophesy, I go back to the Word.
Amen.
I read what God has said about you. So you need to grow in the Word. You need to be interested every time when you hear about the Word of God. You just need to be interested.
Amen.
That's the reason people, they are not growing. They are just after prophecy. They are just after prophecy. Just after prophesying. You talk about prophecy, I can prophesy to you. But when we talk about wisdom, it is you must apply it on yourself. It's a personal empowerment.
Amen.
I can't breathe for yourself. I can't breathe on your behalf. I can just teach you. It is you not to apply the principle. You need to apply the Word of God in every area of your life. And this wisdom comes by what? By hearing of the Word. Not just hearing of the Word, but also staying in the Word. Not just also staying in the Word, practicing the Word.
Amen.
Most of you are good at hearing the Word, but you don't practice what you hear. You don't. That's the reason you're not growing in wisdom. So God does not just want you to be hearers of the Word. God also wants you to be doers of the Word. So the more you do the Word, is the more you grow in the wisdom.
Amen.
You grow in the wisdom. So this wisdom comes the more you read the Word. That's the reason if you read the book of Joshua chapter 7 verse 8, the Bible says that this book of the law must not depart away from thy mouth. You shall meditate in it day and night. Day and night. As you meditate in it day and night, you shall make your words prosperous. So prosperity comes. It's just an addition.
Amen.
The more you stay in the Word, is the more He prospers you.
Amen.
Number four. How must I grow in this wisdom? How must I grow in this wisdom? How must I grow in this wisdom? How must I have access in this wisdom of God? How can I run away from problems, the problems of life? How must I run away from it? Number four. Prayer. There are most of you, you don't pray. He says he's going to pour out the spirit of supplication and the spirit of grace upon the house of David. Supplication, it means prayer. And grace, it means unmerited favor or what you don't deserve or deserving what you don't deserve. So you don't just pray for the sake of praying, but prayer is coupled with grace. There are most of you, you just pray. But there is a level where you don't just pray. You pray with a grace. Where when you speak one thing, when you say a car, the moment you just finish talking about the car appeared. Because in your prayer now, there is the grace.
Amen.
So you must grow in prayer. You must grow in prayer. The more you have communion with God, the more your spiritual life grows in prayer, the more you begin to prostitute, to open up or to pour out information out of you, is the more you grow. Even Jesus was God, but he was praying. You are not even God. You are not even praying. You just go to bed. You don't even pray. You just eat without praying. God wants you to grow in prayer. Luke chapter 18, verse 1, the Bible says men ought to pray and not to faint. So God wants you to pray at all times. He wants you to pray in the morning. He wants you to pray in the afternoon. He wants you to pray in the night. You must make prayer as a habit. You must make prayer as your friend. The more you make prayer as your friend, is the more revelation and insight are revealed through prayer. That's the reason every time when you pray, you feel burdens being lifted. You feel yokes being broken. Because it is the wisdom of God inventing the weakness of a man.
Amen.
You need prayer. That's the reason before I prophesy to you, I tell you pray. There are some certain people, they can't pray. Came to him and said, Master, teach us how to pray. Like the way John has taught his disciples how to pray. And Jesus said, when you pray, not when they pray. So there are different kind of prayer here. The prayer of John is different, and the prayer of Jesus is different. Learn how God prays. He wants you to learn how to pray. There are most of you who don't know how to pray. Even if I tell you, let's pray for 1 hour here, that's when you will see. Some of you will run away here. Because that's the reason you can't have this wisdom, because you can't pray. You can't pray. And if you can't pray, you can't have this wisdom. Do you know?
I receive.
When I pray, the divine wisdom comes on my life. The moment it comes on my life, I'm able to see who you are. That's the reason if you've discovered, when I want to prophesy to you, the first thing I'll pray. The more I'm praying in the spirit, is the more the wisdom of God.
Amen.
The wisdom of God is beyond human understanding. Some of you, you even get shocked how I even know when you were born. Because now, I am praying, not just praying, but praying in the Spirit, praying in the Holy Ghost. Praying in the Holy Ghost. Jesus was praying. Even the Bible says in the morning, he separated himself, he went to a place to go and pray. Some of you just wake up in the morning, you just go for work, just like that. They fire you, you come to church, you say, Papa, they have attacked me. Develop a character of prayer if you must have this wisdom. The last one. Also, the wisdom of God is impartable. Remember, there are people that carry this wisdom. If you had this wisdom, there was no need for you to come to church. There was no need. You would have solved your problems alone. confirm that you are barren. You are barren. And you are coming to church. For what? What you are going through, you need another level of wisdom to give you solution. If it was very easy, you would have impregnated yourself. But because it is not easy, you must look for a person that has the wisdom to sort out your problem. What do I mean? There's a reason. How must you get this wisdom? The number last point is that you must have a man of God. Not just a man, but a man of God. Not a man of men. They are men of men. But you must have a man of God. A man of God. Do you have a man of God? Huh? Do you have a man of God?
Yes.
Where do you run to if you can't? You don't know where to go. Where do you run to? If you know everything, why are you seated here? Which means there are things that you don't know. You need another man. Which means what you are looking for, somebody outside there has it. May you meet your destiny helper.
See.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Lift up your hands. Say, Father.
Father.
Cause me.
Cause me.
To have access.
To have access.
In the divine wisdom.
In the divine wisdom.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Rise up on your feet. I want to declare. And the moment I declare, it is up to you to sow. Lift up your hands. Lift your hands. Hurry up. I decree and declare.
I receive.
Amen.
Amen.
I decree and declare.
Amen.
Lift your hands. Whatever I'm going to declare, look, some of you tonight, the spirit of wisdom.
Amen.
Will come.
Amen.
And tell you.
Amen.
What you must do.
Amen.
I pray for you.
Amen.
May the spirit of wisdom come upon you.
Amen.
May the spirit of wisdom come upon your business.
Amen.
May the spirit of wisdom come upon your career.
Amen.
May the spirit of wisdom come upon your ministry.
Amen.
May the spirit of wisdom come upon anything you touch.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will never be stranded in your life.
Amen.
The wisdom of God will cause you to run away from problems.
Amen.
The wisdom of God will bring opportunities beyond your sight.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If there was something trying to attack you or to limit your life,
amen.
May the wisdom of God cause you to run away from it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I prophesy to you.
Amen.
If there was any wisdom of Satan.
Amen.
Hindering your destiny from moving forward.
Amen.
May that wisdom of Satan be consumed by the wisdom of God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
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 Amen.
I prophesy as a prophet of God.
Amen.
I prophesy as a man of God.
Amen.
If there was a wisdom of Satan.
Amen.
In your business.
Amen.
Career.
Amen.
In your ministry.
Amen.
In your marriage.
Amen.
That wisdom of Satan.
Amen.
It is consumed by the wisdom of God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Tonight you shall experience overflow.
Amen.
are shattered by the satanic wisdom.
Amen.
The way you are shouting wisdom, I don't like it.
Amen.
Every door shattered by a satanic wisdom.
Amen.
That door tonight it opens for you.
Amen.
Yes, it opens for your
Amen.
It opens for your career.
Amen.
It opens for your business.
Amen.
I see business opportunities.
Amen.
I see marriages coming.
Amen.
No more disappointment again.
Amen.
No more limitation again.
Amen.
No more rejection again.
Amen.
No more stagnation again.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every wisdom of Satan.
Amen.
They say that you will never go anywhere.
Amen.
They say that your business will never go anywhere.
Amen.
They put you in the cage.
Amen.
By the divine wisdom of God.
Amen.
I remove you out of that
cage. Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
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 Amen.
Lift up your hands and begin to declare.
Amen.
Lift your hands. Lift your hands. This lady, there is a problem in your marriage. There is a problem in your marriage. There is a curse that was imposed over you. And in your family, there's a struggle in people getting married.
True prophet.
Even you.
True prophet.
You are struggling.
True prophet.
I see a divorce.
Yes, it's true.
Is so much in your family.
True.
When I look at the children, I'm asking God, why are these children? There is also a case where people are not, they are not married, but they are having children.
True prophet.
Is
true.
It true?
True.
Now, that wisdom of Satan.
Oh my God, amen! Amen!
Lift your hands. Whatever wisdom that has said,
amen,
that you will not settle,
amen,
you shall look for it,
amen! Amen!
You shall look for it,
amen!
You will never see it anymore,
amen!
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Bring that lady here. Bring that lady here. The curse or the wisdom of Satan, it breaks over your life. Power. Break. I break that curse. I break it. Yes. You shall get married. In your body age. You shall get married. Yes. You shall get married. Take in the name of Jesus. Yes. If you are here, you are.
Amen.
Yeah, man.
Power.
They put you in a calabash. They put you in a calabash. They said that all of you women, you will never get married. In your family, no woman is married.
True.
Is it true? Now,
true.
The Lord says the wisdom of Satan,
ooh,
it is broken.
Amen! Amen!
celebrate. I don't know what
you're waiting. Yes!
There is a new season. The people who know how to receive the prophetic
word, amen.
I would have continued to prophesy.
Amen.
The Lord has heard you.
Amen. Amen.
What's born in June?
My brother, my elder brother.
Your elder brother?
Yes, prophet.
Is he married?
Yes, prophet.
He's married. What is happening in
this? He's going through.
He has got two divorces.
Yes.
Who was born in February?
It's my other brother.
Your other brother?
Yes.
Is he married?
Yes, prophet.
Huh?
Yes, prophet.
What is happening to his marriage?
He's divorcing.
Who is born in June?
Go deep, Papa.
June.
Go deep. My father.
You've forgotten. Now, in your family, there is no one who is married. But the Lord says to me,
amen, amen,
amen.
Wait,
Professor.
Between July,
yes, Papa.
What's born in July?
July.
You have forgotten. There is a father of your boy or what? Between May, July. May,
no,
July.
He was born. Yes, in May, 19 May, Papa. Yes,
Professor.
This guy was supposed to marry.
Yes, Papa, it's true.
The father of your, is it your boy or
my girl, your Papa, girl? Yes, Papa.
He was supposed to marry you.
Yes, it's true,
the
Papa.
The father from your family, they went and attacked him.
Yes.
The man ran away.
Yes,
but the man used to love you so much.
So much, Papa.
Even you was... were in a relationship.
True, Papa.
This relationship did not work.
True,
Papa. I see two men that were supposed to marry you.
True.
And all of them, they left without telling you. Is it?
Professor, did Isaac, the voice of God.
I release marriages.
I receive it. I receive it.
There was somebody like a teacher. But this person is like, you used to school together. But it was like 17 years ago. You were supposed to get married when you were 17 years. Because there's a lot of people that you have met, and all of them, there's a lot of divorce here. Now, God tells me, Kayaba Ladia Suga.
Receive it!
Do you have a child?
Yes, prophet, I do.
Where's the father?
The father died.
He's only
2012.
One.
Yes. Huh? Yes.
One prophet. Child.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Where is the father?
Died 2012.
The father died.
Yes.
Professor! Celebrate Jesus!
You are him! You are him! The Lord says, I must tell you, your blood has been cleansed. Your blood is clean!
I receive!
I receive it.
Your blood is clean now. Even tomorrow, go and test. They will tell you you are HIV negative.
I receive. Thank you, Lord.
The father of your child, he used to love you so much. Very, very, very much. And the time when this man died, because he died a mysterious day.
It's true.
Because I am sick between 9 and 17. I don't know what is this. 9, 17. Because this is a sickness. This is a sickness.
Yes, prophet.
What happened to him?
He was poisoned, prophet.
Huh?
He was
because
poisoned.
This is a stomach. You know, this
yes.
is a stomach.
Yes.
It began
yes.
like growing. And the legs.
Yes.
Now, as I'm looking at this man, between 9 and 17, the Lord says, put 7 on 17. On 17, put 7. Is on 17, you put 7.
24.
Huh?
24.
Okay. The day. When did he die?
2012.
Huh?
2012.
When?
Oh. I can't remember.
when? On which day?
I can't remember the day. Huh? I can't remember the
day. You must go and check. Between 24 and 25. Between 24 and 25. But this thing happened on the 17th.
Yes, yes.
On the 17th. On 25, he began like to vomit.
Yes, true prophet. Vomit.
And then it's like you rushed him to the hospital.
Yes, true.
Hospital. He stayed there in the hospital.
True prophet.
And then when he stayed in the hospital, it's like they could not find, the solution.
True prophet.
And the man died.
True.
Now, I want to tell you, God wants you first to forget that man because another man is coming now.
Amen. I receive. Amen, prophet. Amen. Amen. I receive.
You.
I receive.
You. Come here. Stand up. Come here. I break the curse. Ah! Bring her here. I'm breaking any power. If I be your father, I vow on my oil.
Amen.
This year.
Amen.
You shall find your partner.
Amen. I receive, Papa. Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
You shall find your partner.
I receive.
In Jesus' name.
Power.
Ha. Who is the nurse?
The nurse is my brother's wife. Huh? But the nurse is my brother's wife.
I want to pray for them so that they should not divorce.
He died, prof. She died.
I don't know what is that.
She passed away.
But how did she die? How did she die?
Say she's HIV.
Huh?
Did they say she's HIV?
Now, your brother, is he married or what? Is he married?
My brother also died, prophet, with
the
wife.
He died?
Yes.
He died with what?
Last year, February.
With the same thing?
Heart attack. Yes.
Whew. Lift up your hands. Father, I intercede for these people.
Amen.
Give them faith.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Turn around three times. Go. It is done.
Amen. I receive. Thank you, Jesus.
I shall bless your wedding.
I receive. Thank you, Papa. Amen. Thank you, Papa.
I shall bless you.
Amen. Amen.
Go.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Go. Go.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come to the testimony.
Thank you.
Your case is vindicated.
Thank you.
At work, it is vindicated.
Thank you.
Go.
Thank you, Jesus.
Wow.
Where is your child? Huh? Because it's one. It's one child. Come here. You are a single woman. You have this child, but you're a single woman. Because you are a mother, you are a father. Huh? You are doing everything alone. Because the way it happened, the father of this child, is like there was something that he was supposed to marry you.
Yes, sir.
But this man went for another woman.
Yes, sir.
As I'm looking at you in the spirit, I see you like a woman of God.
Yes, sir.
Because you're a very prayerful woman.
Yes, sir.
Because when I look at you in the spirit, there is another man again now.
Yes.
And this man is like interested in you.
Yes.
And the Lord says you must accept him because this is a man that God has destined you to be.
I receive.
You were trying to reject this man.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
You are trying to reject him.
Yes.
Now, go and call him. Go and tell him sorry. Go and tell him sorry.
Pow!
You, come here. Today I feel the anointing in my hands. Come here. Now, the Lord says you have suffered for so long. You have depended on other people and that they have looked down on you. The Spirit of the Lord says a new season is coming.
Amen. Amen.
This is a season of miracle finances.
Amen.
Miracle finances.
Amen.
The Lord is going to connect you to a person called Evelyn. And this Evelyn, she'll be in South Africa. She'll be dealing with magazines. magazines. And then there will be an opportunity for you to be in every magazine.
Amen.
That's Amen. Where your breakthrough will come from.
Amen.
Now, I want to tell you this. You must heal as soon as possible. Because you have dwelt on the past.
Amen.
When you look at yourself, when you look at yourself, by this time you're supposed to move on. But there are some things that are still holding you. The Lord says you must move on now.
Amen.
You must move on now.
Amen.
If a man appears to you, the Lord says it is time and season for you to settle.
Amen.
Now, it will not be like what happened. The Lord says he's giving you somebody with a heart, a matured heart, a heart to endure, a man who is going to build you and strengthen you.
Amen.
Says the Spirit of the Lord.
Amen.
Go.
Amen.
Your hands are blessed.
Amen.
As I'm prophesying to this woman, all those that are watching me, I release grace. In the name of Jesus, receive grace. In Jesus' name. Stand up. Bring your hands. Give a microphone. Say, in my hands.
In my hands.
Starting from today.
Starting from today.
I shall touch money.
I shall touch money.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Let my suffering.
Let my suffering.
Turn to celebration.
Turn to celebration.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Pick any money here. Pick any money. Go.
Thank you, Jesus.
May the Lord lift you.
I receive.
In Jesus' name.
I receive.
May the Lord favor you.
I receive.
All those that are watching us on Facebook, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord favor you. I want you to know that God has a purpose for you. And I want to invite you for our miracle service this Sunday. It's going to be a powerful service. I want you to come with 3 mantles. And those 3 mantles, God is going to use them as a point of contact to touch you financially, to heal you, and to bless you with whatever you desire. And I want to invite you also for our Easter 3 days conference that is coming in 2 weeks from now. We are having different men of God coming from different countries. They'll be coming to bless us. And I'll be blessing you. And the woman of God should be here also blessing you. So I want you to be my guest on those 3 days. Prepare yourself. Come with your husband. Come with your partner. God is going to touch you in an unusual way. May the Lord bless you. Continue following us on www.prophetdddisaac.org. I believe you are blessed. Thank you so much for watching DDTV Africa. May the Lord bless you. The next time you see my face, I shall prophesy. God bless you. Shalom, shalom. Put out your hands for Jesus. God was showing me number 3. And when the Lord showed me number 3, because in the spirit, I saw Kalanosko Brenisko Valahate.
I receive.
Because freedom is like a breadwinner. Freedom is like a breadwinner. But the powers of your family, they have gone to freedom and they have paralyzed him. It's like now they want to fire him. Because the way I'm looking at freedom, it's like the man is about to find a miracle job, but I see a giant man from your family saying that freedom must not be employed. Not only freedom, but I don't know what is this. Because I see the firstborn. Where is your firstborn?
The firstborn is here in Joburg.
In Joburg. What's the name?
Blessed.
Blessed.
Yes.
Blessed. Because Blessed, is she married?
No.
She's not married.
He is not married.
Where is she?
He's here in South Africa.
Is he a person? Is he a man or what?
He's a man.
He's a man. Blessed. Amen. Because Blessed, as I was looking at him, I saw him into transportation business. Transportation business. Transportation business. When I looked at him, it's like also all your children, they are suffering. They are suffering. They are suffering.
Yes, man of God.
Now, I want to pray for you. The moment I pray for you, and I've given you 21 days from now.
Yes. I receive. All I receive your children, of God.
They will settle. They will settle. And God is saying he's canceling the spirit of death over your family.
I receive.
You will not lose anyone this year.
I receive.
Not only the spirit of death, but God is canceling the spirit of poverty.
I receive, man of God.
If you have the spirit of poverty, I cancel it in Jesus' name.
I receive.
In Jesus' name.
I receive.
In Jesus' name.
I receive.
Do you know this?
No, I forgot, man of God.
Okay. Do you have somebody like Philip?
Philip.
Philip. I don't know how. Philip.
No.
You must call your son, Freedom.
Yes.
Ask him about Philip.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, man of God.
Call Freedom. Ask him about Philip.
Okay, man.
The one who's going to give him the job. Yes. Be called Philip. His name will be Philip. Okay.
Man of God.
Now, tell Freedom the first money he must not eat it. The first money he must give it to you.
Okay, man of God.
And you must bless him. You must pronounce a blessing.
Amen.
That will be settlement of all your children.
Amen.
Have you heard me?
Amen.
Go, it is done.
Thank you.
Put up your hands for Jesus. Clap your hands, clap your hands. Sit down. The Lord has done it. Why are you looking at me? Huh? Why are you looking at me? Where have you been?
At home, man of God.
What were you doing?
My mother is
last
sick.
Last Sunday, were you in church?
No.
I did not see you. The Lord says the same way you work on people, the same way you have a good heart to render help, that's the same way also your father is being healed now. The first thing that God is dealing with, the Lord is dealing with diabetes. And is dealing with cancer. When you go home, he's already healed.
Amen. Amen.
He's already healed. So let's talk. When you go home, you know Jesus, the Bible said a centurion man came to him. He said, Master, only speak the word and my servant will be made whole. And the Bible says, the moment, the same time when Jesus spoke the word, it was the same moment when the servant was healed. Now laugh. The Lord has done it for you. Your father is healed. Be of good cheer. I know you're the only one who loves God in your family. You're the only one who loves God. That's the reason there's a lot of burden on you. There are some of you who love God too much. That's the reason they continue to persecute you. Don't worry. The Lord has done it for you. Put up your hands for Jesus. You. Where were you? Where were you? Where were you? Where did you go? For 3 weeks, I did not see you. For 3 weeks, I did not see you. Where did you go?
Papa, I'm struggling to see if my woman will come along with me. At times, when I was waiting for her to come back to work, when he came back, he said she's tired. Even me, I became weak, so I was struggling. But thank God today we are here.
What?
She said she's tired. She needs to rest. So I became weak to come. So thank God we are here today.
Oh, she wants to rest. Has she waked? There is a big demon in your house that requires you to pray. Take 4 days prayer and fasting.
Thank you, Papa.
You know, you may think like I don't know you. I told you that when I look at all of you, like last Sunday, she was not in church. Yeah, this is my daughter from Soweto.
Yes, I was in church. I was sitting
there. Were you in church?
Yes.
From Soweto?
Yes, Prophet.
Okay. You sat with your son, eh?
Yes. No, he was at the back.
He was at the back?
Yes, Prophet.
Hey. Ah, first time.